Today, we're going to make a dog coat out of a kid's jacket. So, it is freezing cold outside here in Calgary today, and it's way too cold to be outside enjoying ourselves, and it's also way too cold to be outside without some kind of protection. So, I've gone and found this children's jacket from a secondhand store. It was a couple of dollars, really wasn't very much. And I'm going to turn it into a dog coat. Reasons that I'm going to do this include it's economical. The total cost of this project should only be less than $2 or $3 worth. Other reason for doing this is it's a good way to recycle or upcycle clothing and make something that really has already lived a good life, live another good life, by helping the dog stay warm. It won't take very long, and what I'm going to need is this coat. I have a little bit of extra sizing that I'm going to get, and a pattern. Okay, so I have my coat. I have this ribbing that I'm going to use. Now, this ribbing is left over from a project I did years ago. It's not really required to do something like this, but it gives a little extra give to the final product. So if your dog puts on a few pounds or if they're very active, it helps give them a little more movement. It makes the coat more comfortable. I also have a pattern, and this pattern is based off of a dog coat that my dog's already had in the past. I've made this pattern out of cloth so they can reuse it multiple times, and I'll have a picture of this in the link. So that's going to be the belly, and that's going to be the back. So in this case, for this back pattern, I'm going to create a final product where the zipper is going to be right along the dog's back. There'll be an opening for the harness, and remove the hood. Now, a dog's back is fairly wide. In my dog's case, you'll see that this coat is going to take most of the pattern for the dog's back. Then, for the dog's stomach, I'll be using the back side of the coat. And the dog's stomach pattern fits about like that. I'll probably cut it a little bit longer here. This is fairly tight in that area. Other challenges for this product. This is a really cute coat, but it's also totally reversible. And it means that the front side and the back side aren't connected. So as I cut it, I'm going to end up with two layers, and I'm going to have to make a decision about how I want to handle the reversibility of the coat. When I'm done, I should be able to zip right up the dog's back, and I'll use this ribbing a little bit on the sides right in here to give it some give. So the first step in creating something and upcycling something is you have to deconstruct it a little bit. So take your scissors. First thing you got to do is zip up the zipper so that you have as close to the final product as possible. Thank you. that is part one and part two of our dog coat.
All right, I'm back.
So I've done a few things in the meantime. I have finished the edge along the bottom, finished the edge along the top. I just tucked the two sides down and sewed them down. It is one of those 80-20 things. I'm going to have to do that one again. But you just want it to be good enough that it holds it all together. I've measured my dog's neck, and while technically it is enough space, enough length to get all the way around, one of the areas I find when sometimes he's not comfortable is if the neck's too tight, especially when there's a little bit of collar like there is on this one. So I'm going to take some of my ribbon, and I'm going to build a little bit in into the collar. So I'm going to join it right here. A little bit in, right in here, maybe in my backside method, on both sides, and so that he has a nice comfy bit of stretch, and so it will feel good. And then I'm going to test it around his neck and see how he does. And I'll also maybe do something similar right along the edge of the leg here. Okay. Progress I've made. I have taken the two sides, I've introduced the ribbing. I measured my dog's neck and figured that should be about the right amount to be comfortable and to let him move and for the coat to feel good. So that part fits really well. Now, I also checked around here. It turns out somebody's been plumping up a little bit lately, and this pattern is snug. So rather than squeeze it into a snug coat, which I also suspected may be the case, I'm going to put a little bit of ribbing in there. Doubled up, I find single layer ribbing is often judging by how chunky his middle has gotten, I'm going to try and make this a better finish. Which we got some of this one. So, hold up. Right there. Seam allowance. Everybody who's much more precise and technical than me. So now I have two chunks of ribbing and a whole bunch of extra ribbing, which goes into my collection of things for the future. And I'm going to take this and double it. I'm going to sew here and sew here. And do a little finishing on the bottom. And that will be the bottom half of the coat. So I'll show you what that looks like once it's done. Okay. An update. So I have taken that ribbing and sewed it in here and here. Struggled with ribbing a little bit, quite frankly, because it kept jamming the machine up, but we're done. We have it in there. You notice the seams don't match up here quite right, but that's not a problem because the arms still need to go back on. On the inside, I did not try to contain or maintain that idea of being reversible. I just sewed some seams in and let them be what they're going to be. If I had more time or energy or interest, I could finish it up nice so it's reversible. But generally speaking, I don't really want this part on the outside. I want it next to my dog, keeping him warm. And I want the little bit of sort of wind resistance you get out of this side on the outside. So I'm going to try it on him. And I'm also going to try and show you how to fit the arms on. The arms are too long. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to actually put it on the dog and then pin them up to the right length so that when I go back on, they won't catch on him when he's trying to run around and do his thing.
Hey dude, you are looking fit and fly in your coat. Okay, so let's have a look at how it fits so far. What do we have? It's a little loose at the bottom. You want to sit up, sit for mom? No? Ah, there we go. Let's see the fit. So, not wanting to share. Let's try this side. Yep. Well, it's definitely comfortable to sit in. All right. So the next thing we're going to do is we're going to take this arm. See if I can do this with one hand. Yeah. All right, so what do we have? Michelle, sits it. Nice. All right, so I have the sleeves pinned, sitting. They're a little short. By the time I'm done getting them all attached to the main body of the coat, they should be fine. Coat is a little long in the back, but I may, on final adjustment, make an adjustment. We'll have to see. So, here we go. Very good. Thank you, buddy.
Okay, an update. So, I am starting to pin the sleeves on. There's lots of things that I just like to figure out as I go, but one of them is not putting the sleeves on. You can either pin them or it just isn't going to work. Now, in this case, because I've added the ribbon, the sleeves are a little bit smaller than the holes. So what I've done on this one, and I'm going to do the same on this one, is I've sliced up a little bit here to basically make the whole circumference bigger. And I've had to just best fit it all the way around. So that's a kind of a best fit pinning job. I'm going to sew it once and see how it fits. And then, if necessary, I'll make any adjustments.
Hey, buddy, look at you. Aren't you looking swish? All right, sit for mom. Sit. Nice job. Look how that fits. Does it feel good? Because it looks super. Yeah, now it's a little bit baggy right here. But I think that's okay. I think all in all, I'm going to clean it up, finish the edges, get all the pieces looking the way I want them to. And, oh, and one last thing. Got to make a little opening for the harness. And this will be a done deal.
Right. So I have finished all the basics for this coat. The sleeves are now on. And as you saw, it's great. Sized it to the dog. Trimmed this in just a wee bit because of the gaps. And I've sewn a buttonhole right here, which I'll open up, and that's where the lead's going to feed through, so he can wear his lead and wear his coat and be warm and cozy for the winter. I'll take some pictures of him in it once I get all the finishing done. You can see here, when I said I had to split the arm seams and then make them fit, that there's quite a bit of difference in there. But that's okay. I'm going to finish all of that up. I'm going to trim it all out. I'm going to zigzag it so it doesn't fray. And it will be a nice, cozy winter coat.
Oh, look how nice your coat looks. Looking warm, looking cozy, beating snow. All right, buddy, let's go.